I'm Marion Short, the CEO of IAP2 Australasia, and I want to take you through an overview of the postnominals program and our thinking to date. Got a lot to get through, so we're going to share a bit about what our members' voice was, the approach that we've taken, how we went about developing the proposed postnominals framework, what those postnominals are, considerations around sustainability, the project model and our staged approach, what the governance looks like, the launch date, and the bit that we're really keen on is asking you for your feedback. IAP2 Australasia has almost 11,000 members throughout Australia and New Zealand. The majority have over 15 years' experience in community and stakeholder engagement and come from a huge range of backgrounds. Our members are really clear on why they want a professional recognition program, but they also want it to be affordable. Our members tell us that they are frustrated with tokenistic engagement and the variation in engagement practices and standards that we see. Our members want to be valued as a professional. They want to be part of decision-making processes, and they want engagement to be valued as a practice. This is why the IAP2 Australasia Professional Recognition Program is so important, particularly the postnominals. It also presents an opportunity to advocate for engagement profession and is a priority project for the IAP2 Australasia Board. We have very much taken an evidence-based approach. We've engaged with subject matter experts, attended seminars and webinars, and completed quite a bit of desktop research. We're fortunate to have an internal subject matter expert on continuing professional development with our professional development manager. So what were the models we liked? We were looking for models that resonated with our organisational strategy, our context, and our resource model. We reviewed a range of professional recognition programs and focused on four in particular: the Australian Institute of Company Directors, Planning Institute Australia, Public Relations Institute Australia, as well as its sister organisation in New Zealand, and the Australian Human Resources Institute. I do want to highlight there are lots of pitfalls with professional recognition programs, including being administratively burdensome and therefore expensive to run. Quite often they're difficult to apply for and retain. They're not valued by their members. They're not recognized by the market. And in essence, they're unsustainable. Therefore, it was really key to develop a strategically simple professional recognition program that would be valued by our members, recognise continuing professional development outside of the IAP2 professional development opportunities, and built on trust rather than an audit-based approach, which is also very expensive to administer. In developing the proposed postnominals framework, we actually prioritised postnominals first, but we recognised that we had to take a holistic approach. Professional recognition programs typically comprise of two legs, postnominals and continuing professional development, and they are intrinsically linked. So we framed them up together, and we will be coming out to engage with members on what the continuing professional development framework looks like, likely to be in early 2022. Developing the criteria for postnominals can be really tricky. Postnominals are a hierarchical system, so a lot of thought needs to go into the levels and how they provide value to members, connect to the organisation, as well as how will they be operationalised and recognised. They present a strategic opportunity to advocate for the practice and therefore need a considerable amount of rigour and effort by members for them to be valued outside of IAP2. Like the GAICD, which is a graduate of the Australian Institute of Company Directors, or the FAICD, a fellow of the Australian Institute of Company Directors. So what are the proposed postnominals? We have chosen six postnominals, and they've been framed around the AICD model, which we felt was the most strategically simple and smart model. You will see them on the screen here, but we have an associate, a member, a graduate, a professional, a fellow, and an honorary fellow. They're mostly straightforward. The challenge is the PIAP2, the professional, and a lot of thought with the support of the IAP2 board and our professional development committee has led to the development of the criteria and process that is part of this engagement project. The ongoing sustainability of the professional recognition is important and needs to consider members' wants and needs, the ability to achieve the required continuing professional development points, The cost of implementation and the ongoing management and resources required, including the ICT investment. The rigor of the program, including the criteria, assessment process, and recognition and value of the post-nominals. We also consider the brand value and standards of IAP2. We want to avoid those common pitfalls, that bit of a bad rep. You know, it's widely accepted that professional recognition programs can be problematic and resource intensive to develop, implement, and maintain. We want to strip out complexity. Members and the market don't understand it, so you've got to keep it really simple so that it's well understood and valued. We've got to make sure that it's easy to apply for or maintain, and that it's valued by our members and or employers and the wider market. And all of these programs need a really good marketing and comp strategy wrapped around them. So the proposed project model and the staged approach. We are fans of a staged approach at IAP2. It's iterative and we can learn and improve based on our member feedback. It also fits well with a leanly resourced organisation that is stretched pretty thin at some times, so we have to be realistic. Gives us the opportunity to manage ICT implications and costs, so it's financially realistic. And it means that we can deliver the priority area for our members, being the post-nominals leg, without having to deliver the whole professional recognition program. This project is a key strategic priority for the IAP2 Australasia Board, and the governance has been delegated to the Professional Development Committee, which comprises of IAP2 Australasia directors plus two of our licensed IAP2 Australasia trainers. The proposed launch date. We're really optimistic that we're going to launch stage one, being the post-nominals of the professional recognition program, at the IAP2 virtual conference in late October. So what will this look like? Well, it's really dependent on your feedback, but our thinking is the automated levels, being associate, member and graduate, will launch at the conference. This will then be followed by an initial targeted round of the professional category. This is a more complex category and requires considerable more resource in terms of application processes, ICT investment, and the formation and remuneration of an assessment panel. Further rounds of the professional category will then be rolled out as part of our annual work plan, and a plan for fellows and honorary fellows will be developed and built into the board annual work plan.